Less a month, I guess, technically.
Well, now she's getting real used. Put to work. Paying for it if you don't really need it. Next day. Don't have to do that too often. You get more weird stuff hitchhiking. I used to hitchhike at night. How many people do you think you've picked up in your life?
What?
Yeah. Is it almost everyone you see? Or is there some people where you're like, maybe not?
I was thinking about it, but he wasn't even thumbing at the time, so I really wasn't sure if he wanted a ride.
Oh, I see, yeah.
So that kind of, that ambiguity already kind of made it difficult.
Yeah.
Sleep on the side of the road, so I didn't pick him up. Mm-hmm. But, like, summer, which wasn't a lot, they're always going the wrong way, but I had too much
never had anything too weird except, like you said, your worst experience was a guy that just smelled really bad. Sometimes you haven't, it's usually been no space kind of situations.
Yeah, no space or the heebie-jeebies.
Like, yeah.
You know, that's all you got.
For sure.
I'm the only person on the road. I don't generally pick up hitchhikers when I'm with other people.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, unless we've talked about it already, but I don't think I ever have. But I don't often get the luxury of having a partner anyway, so. Nice to travel with other people.
Well, definitely, especially driving long distance. And a lot of times people pick you up hitchhiking because they're like, yeah, I'm driving a long ways. Wouldn't mind sharing the road. Someone to talk to.
Yeah.
Someone to keep me awake.
I usually just listen to podcasts and stuff because, to be honest, like, especially the route that I'm taking in a couple of days, there aren't really, not really anyone to pick up anyways.
Running along the Northern Ontario route?
You ever get stuck in Wawa?
I have not, but it has that reputation.
Like, yeah.
It's legendary.
It's the place to not stop.
Yeah. Part of me almost wants to stop there just because I've always gotten rides straight past it every time we went through.
I mean, you are documenting stuff.
Yeah, right? So it's kind of like...
It'd be pretty pretty to understand why it's such
yeah.
a legend.
Yeah.
You could have a segment just on its own, like infos for future hitchhikers.
Yeah. But what happens when I got dropped out there? Like, my first ride to Winnipeg today, I, like, got dropped off, like, set down my bag, started to put a glove on while I just lazily threw a thumb out, and, like, the third car that drove past picked me up, and I'm like, huh, that was unexpected. What if I go to this legendary hitchhiking spot, supposed to take days to get a ride, and then it's just, like, three cars in?
I mean,
I think that would be pretty funny.
You can interview people and be like, what is your opinion on hitchhikers?
Yeah.
I got a friend who drives long haul all over North America. He just moved here from Europe.
Yeah.
I mean, he probably could offer some insight on that too. Although they probably might have a policy of not picking up hitchhikers.
They do. Most commercial companies, you're not allowed to pick anyone up. Insurance liability stuff.
I gotta sign special papers if I ever want to do a ride along with them.
Yeah.
Makes sense.
So only ones that pick you up now are either owner operators. Or people that don't care about the company's policy.
Yeah, hey, if we get in an accident, please crawl away.
Yeah. But I've had some truck drivers, and I find they're, like, taking a big chance on me. Twice it's happened, where we drive wherever they're going. They're like, all right, I'm heading home.